Buckner at 30-1 with Angel Cordero Jr. completes the field. 13 years ago, the coaching club was a very special renewal because it was won by Ruffian, and it was the last victory of her career. Charlsie, what's your first recollection of that great filly?
It was in the spring of 1974, Dave. I was working for Frank Whiteley, and Ruffian was one of several very promising two-year-old fillies he had in the barn. We knew she was good, but nobody was really prepared for what she did the first time she ran right here at Belmont Park. She equaled the track record as a two-year-old. She won by 15, and she wasn't even the favorite, but that was never to happen again. She made a career out of setting or equaling track and stakes records, and she was a legend.
She won five races at two, five races at three. I was fortunate enough to call 9 of her 10 races, and they just seemed like yesterday, as this does. Stuart Janney Jr. leading her into the winner's circle, the owner there following the coaching club American Oaks, the race that made her the undisputed champion in the record books and in the hearts of racing fans everywhere. It was her toughest victory because she only won by 2 3/4 lengths.
Usually, Dave, we saw her winning like this, just drawing off and hiding from the field. Frank Whiteley and Jacinta Vasquez both felt that we had yet to see the best of her, that she hadn't really learned to run. But she didn't just beat her competition, she often devastated them. A filly would move to Ruffian with everything they had, and she'd just glide away and leave them brokenhearted. No horse ever finished in front of her. Her only loss was dealt to her by her own body.
They will never fill her hoofprints in the stretch at Belmont Park, and every time the coaching club American Oaks is run, we will always think of Ruffian.